Hi, my name is Ben Hoover. I'm a hardware design engineer for Keysight Technologies working in the Power Analyzer group. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about using the new Power Analyzer that we just worked on, the PA2203. It's a three-phase Power Analyzer. I'm going to talk about how to use it to measure signals on a variable frequency drive. So I've got a block diagram of what I've got wired up here. I've got 120 volt single phase line coming into this variable frequency drive. The variable frequency drive is generating three phases out. It's in a delta wiring configuration. It's driving a three phase AC induction motor. And then that induction motor is mechanically coupled to a DC generator, and that's connected to a load. I've got my power analyzer wired both on the front end, looking at the 120 volt single phase line in, measuring it with a 50 amp internal shunt and a voltage measurement. And these are all isolated current and voltage measurements. And then on the output, I'm measuring U to V, V to W, W to U as a delta wiring configuration, measuring with each one of the voltage inputs and current inputs 1, 2, and 3. Again, these are 50 amp internal shunts. So I'll go ahead and turn this on. This is the motor drive. It turns the variable frequency drive on, and immediately you can see the voltage waveform, the current waveform, and the power waveform on the screen. This is the default setup of the instrument. So I can actually see that it's, you know, a PWM signal that's trying to generate a sine wave here. And this is just one of the three phases being driven into the motor. And so I can zoom in on that and see the PWMs changing pulse widths and see that it's running at about, I think it's about 8 kilohertz, around 8 kilohertz. It modulates it a little bit. And then I can zoom out and look at all of the channels here. So channel 2 is phase 2 or U, and channel 3 is phase 3 or W. So I'm measuring directly across the each one of those delta configuration legs, and I'm measuring the current going into it. You can see the current's somewhat sinusoidal. I can actually turn filters on. And look at the sinusoid that it's attempting to generate. And there, if I bring channel 1 up to the front, you can actually see the sine wave. And I'm running it really slow now, so the voltage is relatively low compared to the rails that it's switching to for the PWM, generating a small waveform. I can actually measure the size of that waveform if I get my trigger down there where I can actually measure it. And I've got a sinusoid that's 36 volts, but the peak-to-peak on this thing was, on channel 1, the peak-to-peak was 100 volts, but if I look at the peak-to-peak on the actual PWM signal, I can look at channel 2. That's the frequency. Channel 2, peak to peak. And that's measuring about 700 volts. So that's the rails of the actual VFD, the DC rails internal to the VFD. So I ran this other measurement. This is our power quality panel. It actually does a different type of measurement than the on-screen measurements that I was just showing. These measurements are based entirely on what's on screen right now, where these measurements are actually based on a fixed window and their continuous whole cycle analysis measurements. That's what we call CWA, continuous whole cycle analysis. And that's really operating over a time window. And during that time window, it operates. The measurement is evaluated only on a integer number of cycles, and so you get a very consistent, good measurement that's gapless over time. So you can actually data log that measurement over time, and you get a consistent data log over time. So another thing that I can define here is I can change the window of this analysis. Right now it's at 200 milliseconds. That's okay for a 60 hertz signal. As you go lower and lower in frequency, you need a longer window to get a good measurement, to get a number of cycles so that you average over a number of cycles. And so I'm going to change that to a 1 second window, and that should get me a very nice stable measurement there. Right now I'm looking at these signals as individual voltage current measurements. I'm not looking at it as a three-phase delta wired configuration. That's really what I want to know, is if I consider this three-phase system, what's the total power of the three-phase system? And so now I'm going to go into my wiring diagram here and actually change my wiring configuration so it's a 3 watt meter three-wire measurement here. So this is a diagram showing exactly what I'm measuring. I can take that and compare it to the block diagram and where I've got my wiring set up in my block diagram to see that I've actually got everything wired up correctly. It's a very convenient way of showing that. And what that allows me to do is now all the channels got filtered, and that's because as soon as we turn that on, the filtering actually controls all channels simultaneously in that three-phase group. And I can turn on channel 4 here, and that's actually my sine wave input. That's the 60 hertz, 120 volt line in, and you can see it's actually being rectified. You can see the first thing it does is go directly into a rectifier based on that current pulse. That's probably what's happening inside the device. There's no power factor correction, and we can actually look at the power quality measurement on that channel and look at what its power factor looks like. I can change my trigger source to channel 4. So now you can see the power factor is actually quite poor at 0.4. The angle doesn't really mean anything because it's not a sine wave. It's really a very non-linear response. I can actually turn up the speed of the motor a little bit. Now I can go back and turn on filters and look at the filtered three-phase waveforms. That'll work. And turn off channel 4. And now I'm actually looking at each one of these guys. There it is. The filtered version of each one of those. One other thing that I can look at here is I can turn on a phasor diagram, and the phasor diagram will show the V and I of just a single channel, or I can show the V and I of the entire group. And so this shows the phase between V and I here. It shows the magnitude of the first harmonic. And so this is really showing us the same angle that you'd get here in the power quality window. If I go and look at one of the phases here, I get 36 degrees there because I'm filtering. If I had turned off the filters, I wouldn't get 36 degrees there because I'm not looking at the fundamental. I would get something completely different because it's really the full PWM signal that it's looking at there. So I'll go ahead and turn off the filters. And now if I look at the analysis, my power factor is much, much lower, and my angle is 72 degrees now, where before it was 36 degrees, and that's because this angle is computed based on power divided by VA. That's how the power factor is computed, and the angle is the cosine of the power factor. or the inverse cosine of the power factor. There's other analysis features that we can actually do here. We can turn on, right now it's looking at power quality. We can also look at the efficiency of the VFD from the input to the output. And so I can define my input power as power number 4, because that's my line in, and my output power as, not power 1, as the grouped three-phase power. And I can see the actual efficiency that this is running at. I can vary the speed of this thing. It runs at 80% efficiency at slow speeds. And as I increase the speed, the efficiency of this thing goes up. So it's just one of the measures that you can make is looking at efficiency input to output on a VFD. Other measures that we could do, or we could look at energy over time, we could look at the harmonics on the waveforms. So we have multiple power quality types of measurements that you could do on this VFD. So in conclusion, I walked you through some of the analysis you can do using the PA2203 power analyzer and how some of the capability of the 2203 helps you look at specific signals on a variable frequency drive.